tide. Through the deep blue hundred is the ocean. We'll control the ocean wide. From down, down, underneath the sea.
I'm Rear Admiral Thomas M. Dykers, retired, bringing you another true account of the Silent Service. This is a story of the 2nd Combat Patrol of the USS Swordfish and of what happened when she was ordered on a difficult and highly perilous mission, which two of our submarines had previously been unable to accomplish. It began in January 1942 during the darkest days of the war when the Japanese tide of conquest was sweeping irresistibly southern. Less than 6 weeks after Pearl Harbor, and the blow that struck us there was only the first of many attacks falling upon our allies and ourselves. Wake Island, Guam, Hong Kong, Malaya, the Philippines, and countless others all had fallen or were under fearful attacks that would succeed. By land, sea, and air, the Japanese were pressing forward despite the desperate and gallant resistance of the meager forces of our allies and ourselves. Of all our outnumbered forces, none fought back more tellingly than our submarines. The USS Swordfish, returning to her base at Surabaya, Java, was doing so in the proud knowledge of having sunk the first Japanese ship of the war. On December 16, 1941, Swordfish had sent the Atsutasan Maru 8,662 tons to the bottom.
Finished refueling, Chester?
Yes, sir. We've got the bugs out of our number 3 engine.
The Swordfish is ready for sea.
Good. I've got a real tough one for you this time.
That's the kind we like, sir.
Well, you got our first kill of the war. You might pull this one off. I don't mind telling you, we've already sent 2 submarines on this mission without success.
What's the job, sir?
Well, here, on the north tip of Celebes Island, the enemy has their far-advanced airfield for land-based planes. It's the farthest spearhead of their attack. And from it, they've been hitting us hard and hurting us, badly. The intelligence reports from the Dutch indicate that it might be the former Dutch airfield located here. But we don't care about that. I don't have to tell you, we don't have enough planes to wipe it out, even if we knew its exact location. But that field's being supplied by enemy ships from somewhere.
Sir, there aren't too many harbors or anchorages here in that area. Looks as if the supply ships are using either, well, Monado on the north side of the island, or Kima on the south.
It looks that way, Chester. But 2 different submarines, each keeping both areas under observation for several days, came back from their patrols and reported absolutely nothing. Now, the Japanese planes that are doing so much damage are operating from roughly here. Now, that means that ships are bringing them ammunition, bombs, fuels, and supplies. Now, get those ships, and we've immobilized the planes.
Sir, this time of year, with the prevailing northerly winds, I think that Kima would be the best possible anchorage, being in the lee. What about the Lembeth Strait here, sir, between Celebes and Lembeth Island? It's very narrow. Does the enemy have it mined?
Well, as far as we know, they haven't. But then we don't know very much. That'll be up to you and the Swordfish to find out. I'll locate those supply ships and get them.
Well, we'll do our best, sir.
The operations officer will fill you in.
I'll see him now.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir.
On Friday, 16 January, the Swordfish departed Surabaya on her mission.
What's been keeping you, Mike? Scared to finish because you know I'm going to beat you? What's that?
What's it look like to you, Dutch?
Canned cow.
Ooh.
Since when you taken to drinking milk? That isn't what you were belting down at Rosie's bar last night.
Who says it's for me?
Come on, Lucky. Chow time.
Where'd you get that?
Followed me down the street last night when I was coming back to the ship. He was yowling for a handout, said he hadn't eaten for a week.
He sure looked it.
So I brought him along. Named him Lucky. We need a mascot, right?
Lucky? A black cat? Aboard ship? Don't you know that's the worst kind of Jonah?
You heard that black cats are hoodoos, haven't you, Gabby?
Come on, relax. He's got a long time to grow yet before he's a cat. Right, Gabby? Besides, I like cats. They bring me good luck.
tire lock around that thing's neck and throw it overboard before it does any harm.
Anybody throws Lucky overboard better be a lot bigger than me or they'll follow him.
A black cat? Boy, you're in a real bad way.
Bad way, huh? That's better than being superstitious like some guys I know.
All right, I leave it up to you, Gabby. You got sense.
Yeah, Gabby, look. Could a little kitten like him be bad luck?
Wouldn't know.
All right, let's get on with the game. Your roll.
Double sixes will bail me out. Come on, boxcars.
Attaboy, Lucky.
At dawn, 8 days later, Saturday, 24 January, Swordfish had transited Malacca Passage. Now she submerged as she neared Kima, the Celebes harbor that had previously been scouted without result.
Take a look at Kima, Johnny. We're less than 4.5 miles offshore. It's as calm as a lake.
Anything in the anchorage, sir?
No, not even a sampan.
Bear is the palm of your hand, Jimmy.
Down scope. Right, 10 degrees rudder, come to course 022.
Right, 10 degrees rudder, come to course 022.
What's our next move, Captain?
We'll take a look farther north. We'll run parallel to the coast, at least as far as the lower entrance to Lumbus Strait.
That's pretty narrow there, sir. Less than 2.5 miles wide in the strait itself, if you figure on going in.
I know it's a long shot, Johnny. At least we'll get a chance to scout the lower entrance of the channel.
You know, sir, since operations brief me, I can understand the wordings on these Dutch charts okay, but, well, depth estimated, possible sandbank, coral reef reported 19.8, unconfirmed since. Now, just how much faith can we have in these things anyway?
Since they're the only ones available, Johnny, we don't have much choice.
At least it's better than nothing, I hope.
Is the channel entrance mine, sir?
Captain Wilkes didn't know. At last report, he doubted it. You see, I want to see if there are any boom floats in the channel. That would be a tip-off in itself if they've got something to protect.
Well, how about Manatta on the northern coast, sir?
Well, if we don't have any luck here, we'll search there, of course. You see, the south side of the island is the more preferred anchorage this time of year, being in the lee.
Come on, baby, let's go. Ha-ha, that's it, boxcars. Well, that makes 27 bucks
you owe me. So quit your crowing, just because you're ahead for once in your life. If I didn't know that these were my dice, I'd figure that you'd bought some educated ones in Surabaya. Where's that Jonah of yours?
Who? Oh, you mean Lucky? Listen, who knows where a cat is half the time?
All right, so let's get on with...
Battle stations, torpedo! Battle stations, torpedo!
Down scope! Take it down to 90 feet.
90 feet, aye, aye, sir.
It's an enemy plane, all right.
He flying high, sir?
No, very low. He looks like he's on anti-submarine patrol.
Well, if they're flying patrol, wouldn't that seem to indicate they've got something to hide around here?
Well, I hope so, Jimmy. Because in this flat calm and in the clearness of these tropical waters, a plane can spot us even 100 feet down if the angle on the sun's right.
Well, let's hope it's right in the pilot's eyes. Yes, Captain. According to the chart, minimum depth in Lembet Straits is 120 feet.
Then we can't go much below 90 feet without scraping bottom. We'll hold our present course. Come to periscope depth for another observation in about 20 minutes.
Sound forward. Reports all clear. No screws. No echo ranging.
There you are, Lucky. Here's your battle station, okay?
With that hoodoo in here, I'll bet $5 we don't get a shot. And five more that if we do, we miss the target. Probably a mine.
I'll take your bet. And if it was a mine, our old mascot here is right on the job.
Up scope.
An enemy patrol boat. She's about 75 feet long. Looks like she's heading out to sea. There's some other small boats. They look like they're on patrol.
Take a look, Johnny.
Wow, we're sure leaving a nice periscope wake astern. Stands out on that calm sea like a billboard.
Down, scope. Take it down to 90 feet.
Well, looks like a wild goose chase, Captain. Nothing at all in those anchorages.
Two other subs came back with that same report, Johnny. I promised Captain Wilkes we'd make sure. So we'll just proceed right on up Lambert Strait for another hour, even if we're wasting time. Don't you make any mistakes in your navigation, huh? You do me a personal favor.
Well, if you put it that way, Captain, I'll try not to.
Now, there's something. Might just possibly be the masts of some fairly large cargo ship. It's too far away to be sure. It's almost on the horizon. There's another set. A lot of small stuff, tugs and sampans. There's some patrol planes, seaplanes anchored off Marai. Take a look.
Yeah, some perfect bunch of sitting ducks for us, Captain.
Sitting ducks, all right. Clark, take a look. Down, scope.
Sir, we can surface close inshore and knock those planes off of the deck gun like clay pipes in a shooting gallery. Or we can ram and sink them without firing a shot.
We can get every last one of them.
No, Johnny, if those are masts further up the channel, we will have found our target, the cargo ships, right? Now, if we sink those planes, the patrol boat and the other escorts, they'll be all over us. We won't get a chance to get a shot into what really counts, the cargo ships. Because without their supplies, those planes and the land-based ones on the airfield will be out of business for a long time, right?
Well, yes, sir. If we can get in that strait, and if they are the cargo ships, and if we can get a shot at them. But if that strait is mined, or if they have booms, we'll never get in. Not to mention getting out again.
Well, the chance is still worth taking. We'll proceed right up the channel till we make sure about the mast, right?
Aye, aye, sir.
Nice going, Johnny. You're square in mid-channel.
There's one of the cargo ships, all right. She's at anchor. Well up in the Lambeth Strait, range about 7 miles. There's the other one. She's anchored, too.
Down, scope. Take it down to 90 feet.
90 feet. Aye, aye, sir.
Nice going, Captain.
Well, we found our targets. Now all we got to do is get them.
This is the Captain. We've spotted two enemy cargo ships that have been supplying their airfields. They are anchored well up in Lambeth Strait. We are proceeding into position to make a torpedo attack on them. Estimate we will be in position in about 1 hour.
Okay, Lucky. Stand by to earn your pay.
For the next hour, Swordfish crept cautiously along the narrow channel, unable in such shallow waters to submerge deeply enough to be hidden from enemy plane observation. With the periscope being raised only for the briefest observations, at intervals of 20 minutes, absolute perfection in navigation was a must.
We're getting set a little to the left by this current. A course of 5 degrees to the right should hold us.
Bring her right, 5 degrees. New course, 035.
New course, 035.
Sand spit building outward at this point. Reported 1926.
1230, let's take a look, huh?
Periscope depth.
Periscope depth, aye.
Like they're carrying supplies across to Lambeth Island. Soldiers and sailors filling sandbags on the beach there. We'll take the nearest freighter as our first target.
Down, scope.
Captain, I hear numerous light screws, various bearings, confused noises.
Very well. We'll be at optimum firing position in 5 minutes. The
Next look we take will be a shooting observation. Now, here's the situation. The nearest freighter, Eyemaker at 7,000 tons, is anchored no more than 2,500 yards from our present position. The farther one is bigger. She'll go at least 10,000 tons. She's anchored at a range of 4,000 yards.
What about the current, sir? With the targets anchored, it'll have plenty of effect on our torpedoes.
We'll just have to guess at it, Jimmy. I'll make an offset on the scope to allow for the current. I'll figure it at 1 knot.
Aye, aye, sir.
Set depth 8 feet.
Set depth 8 feet.
Depth set 8 feet. Tubes ready forward.
Tubes ready forward.
Up scope. This is a shooting observation.
Bearing mark.
020.
Range mark.
2100.
Set.
Fire one.
Number one, fired electrically.
Fire two.
Number two, fired electrically.
Check fire shift targets.
Check fire shifting targets.
Left full rudder.
Left full rudder.
Estimated time of torpedo run, 1 minute, 24 seconds.
Bearing mark.
002.
Range. Mark.
3600.
Fire three.
Number three, fire electrically.
Fire four.
Number four, fired electrically.
Down scope. Aiming point was amidships, the number one torpedo.
Quarter length off her bow and number two to allow for the current.
60 seconds. 55 seconds.
50. 45.
The Swordfish had fired at both ships in quick succession, and the torpedoes went streaking off towards their targets.
Two hit. Take a look, Johnny. She's starting to roll over.
2 minutes. 5 seconds. 10. 15.
They're in a panic on the second freighter's deck, running around all over the place. Number three hit the second target square amidships.
Number four hit.
They're both sinking.
Down scope. Take it down to 100 feet.
100 feet, aye, sir.
Left full rudder, come to course 200. All ahead full.
Left full rudder, come to course 200. All ahead full.
Going to get out four bells and the jingle, sir?
No, Jimmy, they'll probably be expecting us to do that. We'll run full speed for 4 minutes, then cut down to 3 knots. Silence all auxiliaries and try to sneak out.
We'll cross them up, I hope.
Sounds like gunfire.
Shore base batteries, probably. You getting anything sound?
Nothing, sir. Some distant, confused small boat screws on various bearings.
Wait for depth charge.
Sound forward reports no propeller sounds, no echo ranging.
Atta boy, Lucky. You're a real submariner now.
I think somebody dropped something. Well, didn't you hear it, pal? Sound forward still reports nothing, sir.
Couldn't have been from a ship.
Probably a depth charge dropped by a plane, Johnny.
Echo ranging has begun, sir.
Took them long enough to get on the ball.
Way off. Well astern of us. If their aim stays that bad, we'll be all right.
For almost 3 hours, Swordfish crept cautiously, silently down Lembe Channel. Now that her presence had been revealed by her torpedoing of the cargo vessels, her captain did not dare chance coming to periscope depth for an observation during all that time. She moved blindly towards the open sea. Everything depended upon dead reckoning and luck and the question marks on the charts. Distant echo rangings. No sound of screws at all close.
rains again.
What's the channel depth here, Johnny?
Varying from 170 to 180 feet, sir. Also possible coral reef, position uncertain.
Well, we gotta try to shake that plane off.
Left 5 degrees rudder.
Left 5 degrees rudder.
Take her down 130 feet.
Take her down 130 feet, aye.
You better change that coral reef from possible to probable, Johnny.
Past 1600, nothing for the last 20 minutes. Let's go up and have ourselves a look, huh?
Come to periscope depth.
Come to periscope depth.
There's only one plane in the air, Johnny. Right over Kima Bay, about 5 miles away. There's no sign of the patrol ship. I guess we shook them off all right.
Down scope.
Any chance of going after those seaplanes at anchor, Captain?
No, it's too risky, Johnny, with that plane patrolling the air over Kima. Besides, we've immobilized them effectively by knocking out their supply ship. Secure from battle stations. Left full rudder, come to course 050.
Left full rudder, come to course 050.
We'll head for Davao.
There you are, Lucky. Canned salmon. That's the stuff to put hair on your chest.
Appears as though you were mistaken in your judgment, Dutch.
Well, the patrol ain't over yet. But I will say the little fella's done a mighty good job so far.
Jimmy, encode this message to ComSub Southwest Pacific for transmission later, will you? Sank two enemy cargo vessels, anchored in Lambeth Strait, north of Kima. Estimated tonnage, 7,000 and 10,000. Proceeding to Davao Gulf.
I'll be back in a moment with our special guest. And now I have the honor and the pleasure of introducing to you Rear Admiral Chester C. Smith, who was a skipper of the Swordfish on the patrol you've just seen. Chester, we're very glad to have you aboard.
Thank you, Tommy. I certainly enjoyed your reenactment of the beginning of Swordfish's second patrol.
According to the records, the balance of that same patrol contained some rather memorable moments, too.
Yes, it did. Sometime later, we were ordered to Corregidor to evacuate some highly important personnel. It wasn't until 2 hours before we picked them up that we learned that Swordfish was to take out President Manuel Quezon of the Philippines, his family, and various other high officials of the Philippine government.
Was it a difficult operation?
Well, it wasn't exactly simple. At the time, the Japanese had the docks of Corregidor under fire from artillery, so the job of boarding a small boat for transfer to a submarine offshore was somewhat hazardous.
How did you carry it out?
We took President Quezon and the others aboard off Bataan at night without lights. Fortunately, everything went off very well.
And after that?
We had no sooner delivered the Quezon party safely to San Jose Panay than we were ordered to go to the assistance of the United States High Commissioner of the Philippines, Francis E. Sayre, his wife and staff totaling 12 people.
You evacuated them also, didn't you?
Yes, we got them all aboard, practically under the noses of the enemy. And I don't mind saying that they were rather glad to see us. We landed them in Fremantle, Australia.
Sounds like a pretty gratifying patrol.
Yes, we got a great deal of satisfaction out of it.
I'm sure of that. It's been a real pleasure to have had you with us, Chester. Thank you.
Thank you, Tommy.
I hope you will be with us again when we bring you another true account of the Silent Service.
Take her down as often by through the deep blue underneath the ocean. We'll control the ocean wide from down, down underneath the sea. Safe and close, we'll pass the word in the future's yet to be. That we'll say, as long as there. anchor underneath the sea. So rig for dive and make to come. Down, down, go down, down, underneath the ocean. Fearless man, for might be down. In the deep blue, underneath the sea.